The total death toll from the recent earthquakes in the southern Philippines now at 23. Hundreds stranded after an earthquake triggered a landslide in the Philippines' highest summit, Mount Apo. Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte is set to travel to Thailand today to attend the 35th ASEAN Summit. Good afternoon. I'm Carmina Constantino. Dateline Philippines begins right now. Welcome to the program. The official death toll from the series of quakes that rocked the southern Philippines now stands at 23. Seven deths were recorded from the October 16th quake, while 16 more were registered following this week's back-to-back tremors. Majority of those deaths were caused by falling debris. This is why the country's disaster agency is calling on all residents to have their homes properly assessed before returning. The agency warns tremors are expected to continue to rock the region.
Well, what we're saying to the residents of the area in Tulunan and the communities near the epicenter is that it's not safe to go inside buildings as of this point in time. What we're trying to avoid is that occurrence wherein there are people inside structures, another earthquake hits, and then the building collapses on them. We're advising them to stay in the open spaces, in the evacuation centers, and don't insist on going back, because usually what's happening is people who go back are the ones who get trapped.
The tremors affected some 6,000 families or about 30,000 individuals. The country's social welfare department is now ramping up relief efforts.
What we are sending right now are tents, laminated sacks, hygiene kits, plastic bottles for their as their water containers. Mm-hmm. We are also sending food packs. We are also providing psychosocial interventions because we need to recognize that not all are actually equipped with mental instrumentalities to cope up with this trauma that they are experiencing. Eventually, we will be providing cash for work in order for them to cope up with their economic requirements as well.
The Cotabato government preparing to forcibly evacuate four areas in the province after a meeting with the Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology, or FIVOX, Thursday night. Cotabato Governor Lala Mendoza said over 4,000 families will be displaced due to the quakes, with Makilala town sustaining the most damage.
Ngayon ay may deployment tayo para doon sa forced evacuation na gagawin, kasi kagabi lang nagkaroon na ng clear picture ang FIVOX saan pa yung mga areas na mga no-build zone at siguro ay mga technical terms, no? Hindi natin masyado kabisado. Basta merong apat na barangay that needs to be forcibly evacuated. Hindi ko na lang ma-disclose ng barangay, ano, para instant tayo ng panic, ano? Basta we do it quickly, safely.
Three strong quakes have rocked Mindanao in the past 2 weeks. The latest one, whose epicenter was in Tulunan, was measured at magnitude 6.5. More than 200 were wounded, while thousands were displaced as the tremors damaged several structures. FIVOX believes the series of tremors may be related. Still in Cotabato, hundreds of workers and residents are reportedly trapped after a landslide struck Mount Apo. The Office of Civil Defense, Soksarjen, said no one was injured, but the landslide blocked a road in Sitio Tayaban, Barangay Ilomavis in Kidapawan City. Clearing operations are scheduled to begin today. The road leads to a geothermal plant owned by the Energy Development Corporation, which says two of their facilities in Mount Apo were initially affected. They were put on turning gear operation only, and all employees are safe. It adds structural assessments of its facilities will be conducted. The EDC adds some 1,400 residents from their partner community in the area have been given assistance. Over in Davao City, rescuers have been told to pull out of the Ecoland 4,000 building where they were searching for anyone possibly trapped after Thursday's tremor damaged the building. Rescue efforts ended on Friday after all residents were accounted for. The tenants have been evacuated from the building and advised to move to safer residences. A temporary evacuation site is also available in Los Amigos. The building has been cordoned off and local officials recommended to be condemned. Police are deployed to the area to make sure no looting will happen. Over in Davao del Sur, the number of evacuees in Magsaysay town has ballooned to nearly 1,000 families. The town, one of the areas badly hit by the first earthquake on October 16, remains under a state of calamity.
Sa upland areas natin, halos nasa evacuation center na natin. Nung unang lindol, meron tayong apat na evacuation center. Ngayon, umabot na tayo sa siyam na evacuation center. Kasi yung iba nga, nagsilikas na rin dahil malalaki na rin yung bitak at nagkaroon na rin ng landslide yung kanilang mga areas. As of now, we have 967 families na nasa evacuation center. Top of yung mga tao na ayaw na talaga matulog na nasa mga open space lang sila, nasa mga park ng eskwelahan.
Opo.
Almost all of Kidapawan City's 40 barangays have displaced families. That's according to city disaster official Salmer Bernalte, who said most houses have notable cracks on their walls. Meanwhile, Bernalte also confirmed that a demolition order has been issued for the Eva Hotel, one of the worst damaged establishments after a series of quakes in the city this month.
One building, Eva's Hotel, is confirmed flattened. It collapsed, and the Crisis Management Committee has immediately issued the demolition order. But as of developments of today, the management of the building has requested the Crisis Management Committee for a time clearance for them to talk with the insurance of the building.
Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte orders local government units to inspect buildings, saying, quote, the earthquake season has come. Duterte directed concerned agencies to provide immediate relief and assistance to those affected by the series of deadly tremors. Duterte spokesman Salvador Panelo says the president is satisfied with the local government unit's response to the disasters so far. Duterte is scheduled to travel to Bangkok, Thailand later today to attend the 35th ASEAN summit.
It's time for the LGUs to inspect all buildings. Umpisahan na nila ngayon. It's the earthquake season has come. I don't know if it will occur again between now and tomorrow. Ang problema nito, wala ako dito sa Bangkok ako. So I do not want disasters to happen when I am not around. Not just for anything, ano lang. Just to be here and do what you can do for your countrymen.
Meanwhile, Duterte's home in Davao City was also damaged in Thursday's quake. The chief executive was there when the quake hit the province.
Saan po kayo kanina nung naramdaman niyo po yung lindol?
Sa bahay, tulog. Tapos nung umpisa, hindi ako nagising sa lindol. Nagising ako sa mga yung PSG, mga babae. Same time na sila but under the sa ano security. Dalawa sila, ginising ako. Sabi ko, bakit siya? Sir, lumilindol. Sabi ko, lindol lang naman yan. Pero nag-upo sila nung medyo lumakas. Sabi ko, pareho man tayo dito, wala mang cover. Magdasal ka na lang, buti pa. Gusto nila tumindig, ako lumabas. Ako, ay, para lindol lang. Wala yan.
Philippine Central Bank sees the country's inflation falling within the 0.5 to 1.3% range in October. That's after the headline figure further cooled to 0.9% in September. The central bank says lower domestic oil and rice prices likely offset upward pressures from higher electricity, water, and LPG rates, as well as higher costs of some food items. Still, the central bank vows to continue monitoring economic and financial developments that could affect the inflation environment. Inflation numbers for October will be released on November 5th. The Philippine National Police Academy rocked by a suspected hazing incident. PNPA spokesperson Lieutenant Colonel Byron Alatog says a cadet was brought to the hospital earlier this week after complaining of stomach pains. But Alatog did not confirm whether it was due to hazing, saying all possible angles are being looked at. PNP spokesperson Brigadier General Bernard Banak meanwhile says if there is proof of maltreatment, the suspect may be dismissed from the academy and face criminal charges. He adds the PNP will never tolerate such an act. Our correspondent Vivian Gulia is following developments in Thailand, where President Duterte will attend the ASEAN summit. She joins us now. Vivian.
Hi, Carmina. President Duterte will push through with his scheduled trip here in Thailand this afternoon to attend the 35th ASEAN summit and related summits, even as his home region, Mindanao, reels from a series of earthquakes which caused deaths and a heavy damage toll. President Duterte confirmed this himself in a press conference in Davao City last night, but Malacanang assures Filipinos that the president remains to be on top of the situation and that he will continue to monitor developments, particularly in the earthquake hit areas. Presidential spokesperson Salvador Panelo says the president will attend all summit events. That's even after doctors advised the 74-year-old Duterte last week to rest and take pain relievers for muscle spasms, which he suffered after a motorcycle mishap. The 35th ASEAN summit plenary is scheduled tomorrow. On Sunday, the president will be having a full schedule with an opening ceremony in the morning, followed by separate summits between ASEAN and China, India, and the United Nations. A gala dinner is also scheduled on that day. The ASEAN Plus 3 summit, which includes China, Japan, and South Korea, will take place on Monday, followed by the ASEAN-United States summit. There will also be a special lunch on sustainable development on that day before the 14th ASEAN or East Asia Summit, the ASEAN-Japan Summit, and the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Summit, or RCEP. The closing ceremonies will follow. During the summit, President Duterte is expected to talk about the long-delayed code of conduct in the South China Sea. Philippine Ambassador to Thailand Mary Jo Bernardo Aragon says there are continuing talks for an early conclusion of the COC, which is expected to reduce tension in the region. Earlier this year, ASEAN member states had committed to exercise self-restraint in the conduct of activities in the disputed waters and to avoid actions that may further complicate the situation. Trade issues between the two economic giants, the U.S. and China, are also expected to be tackled in the summit. The Philippines hopes the two major economies will be able to resolve their issues soon. The country also looks forward to an early conclusion of the Asia-wide Free Trade Agreement involving 16 countries, including the Philippines, known as a Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. During the summit, Aragon says state leaders are expected to discuss coordinated efforts to combating climate change and marine pollution. The Foreign Affairs Department anticipates around 40 outcome documents at the end of the summit and related summits, which are in pursuit of a more inclusive, equitable, and sustainable ASEAN community. This year's summit theme is Partnership for Sustainability. President Duterte will be accompanied by some cabinet officials, including the Secretaries of Foreign Affairs and Trade. Meantime, according to reports, U.S. President Donald Trump is skipping the ASEAN summit and will be represented by National Security Advisor Robert O'Brien and Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross. Carmina, here's an excerpt of our interview with Ambassador Aragon.
Yes, as a country coordinator for the ASEAN-China dialogue, I believe it is to the interest of ASEAN that we look forward to an early conclusion of the code of conduct in the South China Sea. I think this will greatly help reduce tension in the region, which will be conducive to the sustained economic growth of the region, which is a common interest to all ASEAN member countries.
Carmina, President Duterte is expected to arrive here in Bangkok tonight, later tonight.
Local celebrities went all out for the opulence-themed Halloween party organized by Raymond Gutierrez. Take a look at Ara Arida as Marilyn Monroe. Richard Gutierrez and Sara Labati arrived as couple vampire. Bubbles Paraiso was a rich Wonder Woman, and stylist M. Milan channeled controversial actress Gretchen Barreto. But the real head turner, Isabel Daza, who arrived as Marie Antoinette just right before her execution.
Oh, sorry.
And that's today's online edition of Dateline Philippines. Thanks for joining us. I'm Carmina Constantino. Don't forget to like and share this video and leave your comments below.